Ask anyone in the village about Angel and her superbike, and they will tell you stories full of warmth and laughter. I remember roaring through the streets, watching strangers' heads turn. Everywhere we went, people would say, "Wow, she's so gorgeous and so cool. I wish I was like her." I was proud to be seen with her. She had ultimate control and inspired so many to follow their dreams just by following hers. I'm the bike, by the way, and Angel built me out of love to perform. My top is a shiny, sparkly pink to catch your eye. My lower side is matte to remind you of my grounded subtlety. My engine is a loud, soothing hum that ripples through your chest, and my build is strong and sturdy to take on the strongest of winds. We danced around corners as her knee kissed the floor, glided through the streets as we smiled at passers-by, and soared into the sky as my front wheel would lift into the air. We were invincible. We were on top of the world. Together, we could spread joy, laughter, and love to anyone we met. One day, we stopped at a crossroads, and as we ventured on, out of nowhere, a speeding driver had ignored our right-of-way and smashed into us. Suddenly, we were flying through the air, my body spinning faster than my wheels. I scraped across the gravel, each inch leaving a piece of my shiny pink exterior. My mirrors and headlights shattered, my engine broken, and my oil was spluttering across the road. I landed in a bush, but my world was still spinning. I couldn't move. I was naked and silent and hurt. My whole life was in pieces. Where was Angel? I waited in the cold alone as my sparkles dwindled. 3 days passed and I had given up hope of seeing my angel again. Why did she leave me? I was swept up and left in a dump, surrounded by rubbish and old possessions that had long been forgotten. The days turned into nights and the nights into days, and still I lay there. My black oil had long dried up, but I knew I was still alive because I would shake and shiver for hours. Broken toys and unwanted things would try to talk to me, but I pretended not to hear. I didn't think I was like them. I was not born into the world out of sadness like they were. I was meant for more than this, and it pained me that I couldn't inspire them to find their beauty within when mine had diminished so quickly. I would hear the roars of engines fly past, each time remembering the wonderful moments I shared with Angel. I'd spent my whole life with her, and without her, I wasn't anyone. One day, a young man was kicking his way through the dump, searching for love amongst broken dreams. His eyes lit up when he saw me, and he pulled bits of rubbish off that had landed on me and used all of his might to drag me up the right way. I only had one wheel, which was torn and useless like the rest of me. I assumed he would realize I was unfixable and drop me back down where I now belonged, but he wouldn't let go. He pulled and pulled until the night came, and eventually, he opened up a garage door and pushed me inside. Tired but feeling proud of himself, he took one last look at me, smiled, and left. The garage wasn't much, but it was warm. It was dark, but I was used to the darkness. For the first time, I felt safe enough to go to sleep. I was awoken by a flood of light as the garage door opened. The young man had returned and had his box of tools in his hands. Every day he would come with a new part and try to fit it on my broken shell. We would sit together for hours. I wanted to enjoy this connection that we had for as long as I could, because surely one day he would realize that no matter how much he fixed me, I would never be what I once was. Still, he continued bringing in different parts. Sometimes, he would line them up across me and realize they didn't fit. But part by part, he built me up and I grew bigger and stronger. I thought maybe, just maybe, in the future, I could ride again. One day, after fitting a new handlebar on me, he screwed in two mirrors either side, and I finally saw myself for the first time in a long time. There on my left side was an orange strip above a deep green panel. My wheels were lime green in the middle, my seat was a rich black, my right side was blue with yellow underneath, and my tail had a purple sparkle. I'd never seen myself like this before. It was different, but strangely beautiful. The young man decided it was finally time to take me outside again and rolled me up to the side of the road. I was so scared. What if I fell or dropped him? What if someone crashed into us again? With his helmet and leathers on, he straddled me, turned on the ignition, and teased my throttle. The vibrations rippled through every part of me, and I felt alive. I wasn't as loud as before, and when we passed people, they did not look in awe. They just let us be. The young man pulled my throttle harder and pushed us to go faster and faster, and I felt the wind rush through me. My engine sang louder and louder as we rode on. But then I started to feel weak and dizzy. The singing became a splutter, and we slowed down until eventually he turned off my engine. I felt awful for disappointing him. I should have known I wouldn't have been able to handle riding the way I could before. But it was so nice to feel free, even for a moment. But he wasn't upset with me. He wasn't angry. He stroked my tank and told me, "It's okay." Oil started spilling out everywhere and I couldn't stop it. He walked me back to the garage and I fell into a deep sleep. I couldn't get the buzz of excitement that I felt out of my head, and I was determined to soar through the streets once more. For the first time, I tuned into my body and felt where things didn't feel right. The young man listened to me as I showed him which parts of me needed tightening, replacing, or just a little love. My horn was no longer a smooth siren, but a distorted honk. He squeezed it and we both laughed. How imperfectly perfect. Some people are so ready to remove the parts of them that they don't like, discard and throw them out. But those are the parts that make us unique. They are a part of who we are, and without them, everyone would be the same. When I finally felt calm inside, I thanked the young man for fixing me. He laughed and said that it was all me, and that he only gave me parts that I already had. Finally, he sprayed my tank bright pink with sparkles, and even though the rest of me had changed on the outside, I felt renewed and more like myself than ever. We journeyed on for many years, sometimes roaring through the streets, and sometimes taking it slow, as the young man kept me off the verges. We lived in the present moment, and continued spreading love and joy with our stories. I will always remember Angel, but I'm so happy I found my true self and this wonderful man.